chant in his ear and say, listen, be careful.
It's getting now for Ghana to make one here. It's been lifted. Fairly. Back to Nigeria, Okoro and his teammate to do a good job. Sapo here, good control. Sapo looking for Kizito, and this time a shot comes out from Solomote. And Ghana looking to score.
Well taken, and the delight of the Ghanaian fans and the Ghanaian coach, Kanadu, he's very happy. Come over here quickly, and let's get back and kick off, he says. Come on, come and get some water, come back to the corner post. But this young man here, Sapo, has scored a lovely goal and put his own country into the lead, and that's a mouthful of teeth if ever I've seen. It really is well taken. Let's have a look what happens. Takes a shot, turns here, watch, and hits it. That is well controlled. He lets the bouncer, hits his knee, gets a little bit of luck, but put it past the keeper. And that's the first goal that's gone by the keeper of Nigeria.
Steven Sapo, Brooklyn Chelsea striker, 13 goals in the Ghana Premier League, his 10th goal in the WAFA competition. He joins Victoria Adebayo. Daily, the goal game chat here in the competition. What a goal! Massive work for Steven Sapo. I tell you, he breathes hard on your neck. Don't give him space. When you do, this man can't punish you. And he's done that exactly.
Yeah, got a little bit of luck, got the bounce of the ball, and hit it off his knee, but he's got to take it. Give him credit. Third goal.
Control spell. Lovely turn. Patrick Razak.
Themselves in a formation, because a new player came on, no instructions given. Okoro Moses at the back, Eze at the lair, they all didn't know what to do, and this little fella comes on and suddenly strikes terror into the heart of Nigeria. The referee being a little bit pressurized, but as far as I'm concerned, that was a penalty. We brought him down. Being pressured is the man from Senegal at this moment by the goalkeeper, who is, of course, the captain. So he's allowed to have his say, as long as his say is not in any way verbose. Have a look, turns well. Gets it, now he puts it inside. There he goes. Oh! Where does the tackle start? Where does it all begin? Maybe that's all. No, there it is. Inside the box. Very, very tight, but I think the referee got it right. I think I always like to say, if it was your team they gave a penalty against, how would you feel? And I think I'd have to say, you know what? I think we gave a penalty away.
Well, I think you have to look at it. Aremu came out, stick his neck out. Aremu came for a penalty when Nigeria played a bit against Benin in Cotonou, that was the CHAN qualifiers, and that was when Benin spotted Nigeria by a goal to nil. And now he's given up a penalty to Ghana in the final of the WAFA competition. This man scored for the Black Stars of Ghana against the Gambia. And now he has the huge, huge task there to beat Zenwa. Atinga, he's been scoring from the spot there for Accra Hatfok in the Ghana Premier League. And still looking to get another one here. His second goal in the competition. Taps out easily. But Vincent Atinga, Ghana 2, Nigeria 0. The Black Stars of Ghana, home and dry.
Yeah, Atinga takes that well, he really does. In fact, the way he opens himself up, it looks like he's going to put it to the left, right-hand side of the goalkeeper. It's one of those penalties where he comes at an angle, goes around the ball, basically, and then puts it down to the left-hand side of the keeper. So the keeper commits himself to go right. And it's a really, really well-taken penalty. It really is. Calm, collected, and the big man scores again. He gives himself two goals in
Wilson. There it is. Look what he does. He looks like he's going to pull his foot round it, the way he goes up there. He's going to whip that into the other corner, and he opens his foot up and pushes it past the keeper. That is a cool, calm, collected penalty. Well done, young man.
So, Dan control the ball here. Tom Lomote. Razak here, going to put the ball in play. Goes it, Razak. And another penalty to Ghana, Patrick Razak again. That is absolutely amazing.
Oh my word. Patrick Razak has come on and got his team two penalties just because his pure pace, his ball control, and he's taking the defence on, and they don't know how to deal with him. And on this occasion, I think you'll find it gives the referee no chance whatsoever, no option. There it is. Big man sticks his leg out. He's like a giraffe going down at a waterhole. What on earth was he trying to do with that? That was a shocking, shocking tackle. And I'm afraid, young man, and I like you because I've met you a couple of times and discussed things with you, that that was terrible. Well, he finds himself a yellow card.
Steven Ezra played so well. He's been a real pillar of the back there for Nigeria, but this time he disappointed.
Can I say something?
Really?
Right. Think about it. Who's the man taking the penalty?
Steven Safo has been given that responsibility.
Exactly. So what does that mean?
Well, if he's about to hit the back of the net, makes it four for him.
Exactly. That's what I'm getting at.
Yeah. So he needs to...
He needs this to win the golden boot on his own.
Yeah.
But it's heavy. Can he pick it up?
Well, he's gonna
he's
going to get some friends in Brooklyn to help him out.
Let's see what happens.
Steven Safo here. Safo! Makes it three for Ghana. And the right is definitely on the ball there. Nigeria have been taken to the cleaners. Nigeria nil, Ghana 3. End of story.
Yeah, I'm afraid so. With 15 minutes to go, less than 12 minutes to go on the clock. This is
a man that's been trying desperately. Matinga for Ghana.
Oh, no. Give it away. And the goalkeeper nearly missed it. But Patrick Razak kiss it. Razak going. And Ghana can have a fourth goal. Went full cover. Finally, get the fourth goal for Ghana. And this is becoming an embarrassment to Nigeria here. Final of the 2017 WAFU Cup of Nations. And guess what? It's stoppage time. It is Nigeria 0, Ghana 4.
Yes, if you think that's a mistake, you're wrong. It is 4-0. And I'm extremely, extremely delighted with young Patrick Razak, who's come on and he's tormented. What he does here, this is such a bad move. Look, what's happening now? He just keeps going. He's gone, there he's done. Shall I have a go? No. Is there somebody there? Yes, there is. And that's what he does. Selfishly, unselfishly, he just keeps pushing forward. Look, keepers down. Don't know what to do next. I'll have this. And he does. That is 4-0. I don't think, in all honesty, it's a reflection of the game, but I have to say it's 4-0. And I'm afraid Nigeria are going to just have to swallow it this time. Swallow it badly, I'm sure.
Kichuku for Nigeria. Yeah. Huge embarrassment here for Nigeria, if you ask me. It's not the sort of scoreline that you expect to have between Ghana and Nigeria. The last time Ghana scored more goals against Nigeria was a friendly match here in London. It was back in 2007.
Well, what an impression he's made, this young Razak, when he came on, substituted, comes on with about 20-odd minutes to play in the game. In fact, I think he comes in about the 53rd, I've got here written down. 53rd minute, the substitution takes. And ever since there, he's been absolutely dominant in the game, hasn't he?
He charges forward again. The goalkeeper really this time has to find a way to deal with the situation. And he does. We are into
final seconds of the stoppage time, and referee from Senegal will look to blast his whistle for the end of the game, Dawuda Gay. There's another free kick now to the Super Eagles of Nigeria. What a final we've had, Barry. What a final game.
Well, it's been everything, hasn't it? Started off really sort of scrappily. Nothing was doing anything. After 30 minutes, it started to brighten up a bit. Both sides had equal opportunities in the first half near the end. And just on half-time, it was Stephen Safa who took the opportunity with that bouncing ball in the penalty area and put it past the keeper. That was made it 1-0 at half-time. Just got their goal right at the right moment, he did. And then, of course, two penalties, and now tap-in with Gabino making it 4-0.
Final attacking move there for Nigeria. The free kick ball whipped in beautifully. Oh, that is fantastic. But that is the game. Nigeria gets to pull one back, but of course it was too little too late there for Rabiu Ali. 4-1 ends, and Nigeria completely embarrassed here. And, well, I just have to say that.